Tonight, an Action News investigation uncovers a little-known secret kept hidden in the kitchens of restaurants.
The prime steak that you think that you're getting, the filet that you think you're getting, may actually be pieces of stew meat that have been glued together. Investigative reporter Jim Parsons exposes how it's done and why it really poses a health risk for unsuspecting consumers, all of us, Jim.
Yeah, Wendy, several restaurant owners tell me that chefs right here in Western Pennsylvania are using this stuff, meat glue, in their kitchens. Now, critics say consumers are being tricked into thinking they're getting an expensive steak when, in reality, they're getting Frankensteak.
What I would normally use this stuff for would be for stews.
What started as this is now transformed into this.
That looks like a normal piece of steak.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
It looks like a piece of filet mignon.
Yeah, it does.
Chef Doug Shirey is master of the kitchen at Mighty Oak Barrel in Oakmont, a restaurant that does not use meat glue. But on this day, Doug shows us the secret of how it works.
And we're going to sprinkle it in generously, like so, until it's covered well.
Sprinkle some of this stuff on beef cuts that would otherwise have gone into the grinder.
I can already tell that the meat is, like, sticking together.
Wrap it up tightly, put it in the fridge, and 12 hours later, you've gone from stew meat to prime filet steaks, and you'll never know the difference. Not even an expert can tell. It's called transglutaminase enzyme, but most people just call it meat glue.
What is it exactly? What is meat glue?
My understanding is that they're taking the clotting agents out of animals, pigs, and cows' blood, and they're using that essentially to clot together chunks of meat.
Nigel Tudor is a Washington County cattle rancher.
Just like a clot forms, you know, whenever you get a cut, except instead of healing up a wound, it's taking pieces of meat, which are protein, and clotting them to each other into one giant chunk.
So yummy.
Yummy, yeah, exactly.
So this has been sitting in there all night long, huh?
Yes, it has.
The day after sprinkling chunks of stew meat with meat glue, Doug now has one solid loaf that he slices into fillets. And even raw, it's difficult to tell this fillet has been glued together. And impossible to tell after it's been on the grill, even side by side with a real McCoy, a genuine filet mignon steak.
Look at that. It's amazing, huh?
And now it's time for the taste test. Doug and I sample the real steak, then the steak that's been glued together.
You can't taste the difference.
Tastes great.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
Glued meat. Who would think glued meat would taste great?
Mighty Oak Barrel's owners say their supplier recently tried to sell them meat glue.
There's a deceptive quality that we don't like about it, and there's also a health and sanitation quality that we absolutely disagree with.
While the federal government says meat glue itself is generally recognized as safe, food safety experts have concerns.
There's a food safety problem. I think that would be the number one concern.
The County Health Department's Steve Steingart demonstrates how glued meat turns scraps that have been handled and possibly contaminated into the inside of a filet, and that is a problem.
The danger would be that this would be the outside, but now it's the inside because it's bound together. So this would have to be cooked, because if you order that rare, there's a possibility that this steak, there could be growth on it.
The problem is a consumer wouldn't necessarily know they've ordered a glued steak. Federal regulations required glued meat to be labeled as formed or reformed on packaging, but that does not apply to restaurants.
When it comes to meat glue, you don't think restaurants want their customers to know about this stuff?
I don't think that they do, because it just is not something that, once you understand what it is, that you really would want to eat.
Meat is something you buy at your neighborhood local butcher shop. Glue is something you buy at Home Depot. Those two words just don't belong in the same sentence.
And because restaurants are not required to disclose whether or not they're using transglutaminase in your steak, Steve Steingart from the health department says there's only one way to find out. Ask. Ask your waiter, ask the chef, ask the restaurant owner. If the answer is yes, they're using transglutaminase and you're still sticking around, make sure you get that steak well done. In the newsroom, Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.